Black and gold. A one-fall match. And the superstar doing something to that turnbuckle. And being cautioned by the referee, Scrappy McGowan. Some dispute between... All right, so the superstar now moves around and the spoiler moves toward the center of the ring. Superstar, a perfunctory check of that ring post to make sure the turnbuckle was still in place. They lock up collar and elbow back into the ring ropes. Two certainly big giants in the wrestling world, and it is the superstar wasting no time in punishing the spoiler. Although he has not openly accused him, I can't help but believe that the spoiler may have been one of the individuals involved in the punishment that the superstar took outside of the ring when he was jumped and put out of action for about 5 weeks. Into the turnbuckle once again, the spoiler. The superstar set and ready, and Scrappy McGowan breaks it up. Ellering starts to come toward the ring, and the superstar dispatched him very quickly. Once again, they lock up. Side headlock now by the spoiler. And the spoiler drives one into the throat, then the back of the elbow three times to the base of the skull. Remember, next week, here on the NWA Superstar Series, we'll be bringing you Ole Anderson against the Assassin. That's next week. And what a match that promises to be. We'll also bring you a complete update regarding the situation with the World Television Championship, certainly a controversial area. The superstar, not afraid to mix it up with the spoiler, willing to go to Fist City if necessary. To the intensity of the folks watching this match. And now, well, the superstar distracted at that particular moment. The spoiler quick to take advantage of it. Quite an opportunist. Front face lock by the superstar on the spoiler. And the spoiler brings the superstar back to the turnbuckle. Not much time remaining in this hour of the NWA Superstar Series. If we do not have a conclusion to this match, do stay tuned next week, because we will, as we videotape, we will continue to have the cameras roll. In the event there is not a conclusion to this match, we will bring it to you next week. Certainly a prime main event between the superstar and the spoiler. And with only seconds remaining, it looks like that's exactly what's going to happen. We will be bringing you the conclusion of this match next week here on the NWA Superstar Series. So by all means, do join us again next week. Till then, Gordon Solie saying so long.
Thanks for watching the best of championship wrestling. The announcers on this program are employed by Georgia Championship Wrestling Incorporated. Watching the best of championship wrestling. The announcers on this program are employed by Georgia Championship Wrestling Incorporated.
Houston, Texas, is an extremely fine competitor and has a vast knowledge of the martial arts, was a karate instructor, moves with great speed, is equally dangerous both on the mat or on his feet. As you can see right there, got a beautiful head scissors on the superstar, and it is the superstar complaining. And the reason he's complaining is just out of camera range. But over to the left, Mr. Wrestling number 2 is firmly ensconced in a chair. causing some consternation on the part of the superstar. Pritchard gets a quick hammerlock on the superstar. And the superstar made it to the ring. There you see wrestling, too. And you can see the intensity that this man has. Cold, emotionless, expressionless eyes watching very carefully this man. And the superstar is disconcerted. No question about that. The superstar bothered by the appearance of wrestling, too. Quick rip across the eyes by the superstar. Now jams Pritchard into the turnbuckle, smashes his head into that turnbuckle once again. Nick Patrick, the referee, warning. Now it is Pritchard firing back, and Pritchard throws the superstar and the superstar back into those ropes. Suddenly saw the proximity of himself and wrestling too, and very quickly got away from, and look at the superstar. He is beginning to possibly have some real, real mental reservations about everything that's going on. Hip toss by superstar. A rear chin lock, and now you can see the folded arms. There you see wrestling too. Arms folded, sitting there right in that ringside, watching carefully. And the superstar, obviously beginning to lose his cool somewhat. Referee Nick Patrick forcing the break on this one. Pritchard. Ropes and the superstar right on top of him again. Wrestling two. Continues to. And Pritchard exploding on the superstar now. And the superstar started to get out of the ring and then thought better of it as he remembered the presence of wrestling two. Pritchard stalks his man. Pritchard has been, for the most part in this match, the aggressor. And the superstar now just trying to, by sheer size and force, trying to beat Pritchard down, but... and again, the superstar, not himself at all, but now punishing Pritchard once again. Pritchard missed with that one, and Pritchard caught him beautifully with a drop kick. Pritchard up with another good drop kick. Pritchard, a third drop kick, has the superstar, and the superstar leaves the ring. The superstar caught by a salvo from a salvo of drop kicks from Don Pritchard, and now it is the superstar apparently. And wait a minute, the superstar is leaving. And Pritchard gets the victory. The superstar walked from the mat. He literally walked from the mat. Don Pritchard officially goes into the one-loss record book as holding a victory over the superstar. And a very jubilant Don Pritchard, I might add. And I must say that your presence at ringside certainly had an unnerving effect on the superstar.
Maybe now he knows how it feels to have a knot in his gut, how it feels to be very nervous because someone's standing behind him. Well, let me tell you something. That's just the beginning, Mr. Superstar. Wherever you are, at any given time, if I'm not in the ring, I'm going to be where you can see me. You can count on it. I'm telling you. I'm telling you right straight, pal. I've had it up to here with you. Every time I turn around, you're coming after my case. I've done nothing to you, sir, at any time. You're always on my case. Well, the case is over. You and I is where it's going to boil down, pal. And I tell you what, Mr. Soley, tomorrow night, you and I, superstar, Bob Armstrong, Mr. Super D, it's going to be tomorrow night in Marietta. Marietta is where it's going to happen, pal, and we're going to get it down. We're going to get it over. I've had it from you. And it's going to take place in Marietta tomorrow night. Remember that! Marietta tomorrow night is where it's going to take place.
Don't forget, too, wrestling in Huntington, West Virginia, Saturday, June 26th. Columbus, Ohio, the Ohio Center, Sunday, June 27th, July 5th, Gainesville, Florida. And served on these two men, Roddy Piper and Ole Anderson.
Well, I don't think there's going to be too much to worry about. I know Tommy Rich with that hand isn't as dangerous as he says. He may end up with another broken hand.